In this screencast, what we're going to do is use the heat diffusion equation so that we can find the heat transfer due to conduction. And if you recall from previous screencasts, that is Q equals minus K, which is the thermal conductivity, times the area times the temperature gradient, dT dx. So the heat diffusion equation shown right here needs to be simplified if we're going to analyze a plane wall that is steady state, has no heat generation, and the thermal conductivity, K, is constant. So let's see what that does to our heat diffusion equation. Since it's steady state, this term here, which is the density times the heat capacity, dT, the change in temperature with respect to time, is eliminated. Because it has no generation, this Q dot, which is a heat generation term, is also eliminated. Because K is constant, we can take it out of the parentheses here. And finally, because it is one-dimensional that we're looking at, so this is 1D, we get rid of this term, we get rid of this term, and all we're left with now is D squared T dx squared equals zero. So we're going to need to integrate this twice in order to get a temperature distribution. And why do we want a temperature distribution? Well, go back to our original equation for our heat transfer and notice that there is this dT dx term. Once we get the temperature distribution, we can find our Q. So our first integration leaves us with dT dx equals some constant. Our second integration leaves us with that T of x equals C1, this constant, times x plus our second constant, C2. In order to solve for both of these constants, we're going to need two boundary conditions. And what we mean by boundary conditions is that we have to relate a temperature at some x. If we take a look, for example, at a wall that looks like this, and here's the x direction, the wall has a length of L. At x equals zero, we have some temperature surface that we'll call 1. And at x equals L, we have a surface temperature TS2. So these are our two boundary conditions that we'll use to solve the equation. They're called boundary conditions because we're looking at the two boundaries. What happens at the boundaries? How can we relate x to t? Well, if we look at x equals zero, we see that the temperature there is TS1. If we look at x equals L, we see the temperature there is TS2. So let's go back to our temperature distribution. T of x equals C1 times x plus C2. And the easiest boundary condition is to use the first one, which is at x equals zero, T equals TS1. Because you can see we can automatically, since this is zero, solve for C2. Now let's look at the second boundary condition that says at x equals L, our T equals TS2. So when we put that in our temperature profile, it says that TS2 equals C1. Now for x, it's L times L plus C2, which we've already calculated. So now we can solve for C1, which is TS2 minus TS1 divided by L. Let's put it all into our temperature equation. So T of X equals TS2 minus TS1 times X divided by L. Notice that's our C1 times X plus TS1. Now we can find our Q, which is minus K times A dT dx. So we differentiate our T of X with respect to X, and our Q equals minus K times A TS2 minus TS1 over L. If we want, we can also find our heat flux, which is this rate divided by area. So the heat flux is minus K, again, which is the thermal conductivity, TS2 minus TS1 divided by L.